Wow, it's kind of hard to tell if it's just kitschy or I think it's this way organically. I think kitschy steals from this. Unbelievable. So this seems to be the levee. Yes. So those hay bales are to abate the dust. So the sea used to be up here. It's kind of weird because they built the marinas, and all the major investment happened in the late 50s and early 60s, kind of during the Rat Pack era. And then in the 80s, when there was an abundance of water and Lake Mead was completely filled up, the sea started to rise. And it kind of wiped out some of the old places, and then of course nature took its course, and the place eventually became uninhabitable. I mean, hyperbolically speaking, it's pretty bad. I mean, this ground is polluted. It's toxic. It's sewage. It's pesticides. Towards the south, that's the Imperial Valley over there. We're kind of in purgatory here. The Coachella Valley's up there, the Imperial Valley's down there. It would be really awesome if this was ever rehabbed in my lifetime. It can be done. All right, that was Bombay Beach. That's the beach. Oops, let me turn my camera on. So there was two other people there, and that's about all I've seen. I guess me and two other people just are stupid enough to go to the Salton Sea in September. Yeah, so this is a levee right here because the lake was rising in the 80s, and it was about to consume these towns, and it was actually going to cause another problem in the Imperial Valley. All right, what's this? Ooh, the remnants. smelly shores. So with it being 106 degrees and quite humid, and being on this body of toxic water, let's just say I feel great right now. Yeah, this is about as putrid as it gets. There's literally feces that flow into this river, and I'm not just saying that. It really does. From Mexico. Oh man, this smells terrible. Well, I think it's been real, but I don't really see a whole lot of point hanging out here. Man, it smells like it's a combination of like county fair meets the beach. It smells organic. It doesn't smell like the lawn care department of Home Depot. But nonetheless, it smells awful. All right, well, that was interesting. Bombay Beach, definitely something worth checking out. The weird part about this place is that there's not a whole lot, unless you're going to like San Felipe, Mexico, or anywhere else in southern or in northern Mexico. Sure, but I mean, if you're going to Phoenix, you wouldn't go this way. You would take Interstate 10. If you're going from San Diego to Phoenix, you would take Interstate 8. So this is really not, there's not a whole lot of purpose for people to, let me turn this on. But it is now. I see a couple people driving around touristy. So there's definitely a purpose out here. One thing is I haven't seen, I know I saw an episode of Fuel Hauser where he was visiting the market here. I don't know if that's still open or anything. I haven't been doing any thinking. I'm just sweating. A lot of 1960s single wides out here, if you know what I mean. That must have been all the rage. Rocks stuck in my tires. I think what makes it a little bit more weird is that there's, it's basically the same level as the sea right here. So there's these levees, or as they call them, dikes, apparently. That's what the sign says. And I know that those have been there for a while. There's a man watering his rocks. that was fun until he looked at me, and then I got embarrassed for shaming him like that. That's obviously the way he wants to live his life, so I shouldn't make fun, should I? Hello. I'll take a double cheeseburger. Eric. Hi, Carol. Nice to meet you.
No, I wasn't. I'm going to go there on pretty soon. Yeah.
Did you hear about Aubrey? He died last night.
Do you know anything about the guy that waters the ground? There's a guy watering the ground with a hose.
Somebody's watering.
I know. Did you ask him?
No, I didn't. I got embarrassed.
Is it down by the corner?
It was as we go up and then towards the end where I came back.
Okay,
this way.
So that's down by Kyle's place?
We
got a lot of random stuff, man.
Yeah, yeah.
We're all nut cases here.
I love it.
You have to be unique to live here. You can't live here.
Yeah.
We're all troubled people. Don't laugh. You might end up staying here and be one of us. And so that's, yeah, because actually I'm about to reach there this little apron. And I was thinking about going there to sort of play that wedding and getting some of it, because we're really good at like mortar. Thank you very much, my friend.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're off?
Have you seen our patio?
What's, have I?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
The bathroom is called the Infinity Bathroom because it's got the mirrors all around it. You can like see your butt in infinity.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it took me 20 minutes to get out of it the first time I went in there. Oh, damn. We've got patio.
Oh, right on. This is great.
More animals on my leash. Did you have a leash down there?
And you got a full bar.
Yep, and when I'm working, I can run just about anything. If you have an ingredient, I can make it.
Oh, right on.
My blender. But it goes all around and kind of a little bit like Winchester Mystery House.
I didn't know that you had so much capacity here.
Yeah, well, when the season hits, which is like next month, all the spas fill up, and then we got our art people and we have bands and live music all the time. We pretty much go slam jam.
Wow. You definitely should come back. Yeah, I can see why. Thank you very much. Place is much better than I thought it was going to be. Cash only, and they swear they're going to get a credit card machine soon. All right, well, that was the ski inn, or is it the sky inn? I think it was a ski. Full bar, menu, very friendly staff.